Good morning, everyone. This is Kamikawa Kaolin. I reported that I experienced the wonderfulness of UD Talk last time. Only in UD Talk, you cannot add YouTube subtitles, timestamp. I'm really sorry about that. However, the author also knew that point. From a CSV, with timestamp information, file created from UD Talk, the tool, subtitle data conversion kun, that creates SRT files has been released. https://jimikudata.udtalk.jp I tried this, but it's a tool that works on the web, so even in his Safari on the iPhone, I found that it can be used if it is a PC version site. This point is very convenient. As for how to use one, create a CSV file with UD Talk. You can get it from menu, send meeting log by email, and send email to yourself. 2. Unzip and open the CSV file on your iPhone. I used an app called CSV Reader. 3. Repair typographical errors and save as a CSV file. 4. Read this data into subtitle data conversion kun. And if you specify the creation of one line of characters and the presence or absence of punctuation marks, he created the SRT file. Divided to some extent, the SRT file was created for the time being, but this phrase wasn't something I could use. If it is not a meaningful chunk as a sentence when translated into English, there is no point in adding subtitles. It's easy to say, automatically divide by machine, but although it can be understood by Japanese people, it is far from a level that can be translated and understood by people from other countries. This is no different from YouTube subtitles, isn't it? Therefore, the timestamp of UD Talk is not at a usable level at all. Again, Vru has a long day to work on this timestamp. If you paste a sentence that is arbitrarily divided by humans, 22 characters per line, created within 2 lines per phrase, it will give you a timestamp in one shot, several seconds, so this pleasure cannot be abandoned. So to create subtitles, at the moment, UD Talk, transcription, plus, Vru, timestamp. It's the easiest combination to use. For now, both are free to use. However, this UD Talk has various uses, isn't it? Everything that Pip can do in Safari can do transcription and simultaneous interpretation. It means that. In addition to Pip with Safari, we recommend the extension application Pipifier. Even if you just think about it, one, transcription and automatic translation of YouTube videos and news. Two, transcription and automatic translation by displaying the MBTV application and Japanese TV on Pip. Three, transcription at meetings, lectures, and classes. Four, transcription at web meetings, etc. You can also use it. I look forward to future developments. That's all.